Namaste. Welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today we are going to see a very interesting Diwali brunch. I'm calling it a brunch because it is going to be quite a heavy breakfast. And Diwali generally in South India we get up very early in the morning, say by 4 a.m. So by around 6-6:30 everybody is quite hungry and we have a lovely spread. Now in this brunch I am planning to prepare a wide variety of items. I'm going to have mini idli and sambar, keera vadai, rava khichdi, and also for the sweet we are going to make pal puri or pal puri. So we'll do it in a particular order. I have done a little bit of pre-preparation so that the video does not take too much of time. The pal puri is like puris we have to roll out. You can use either with wholly plain flour, that is maida, or a combination of atta and maida or atta alone. So today I have just made a dough of atta, that is wheat flour, and kept it aside and rolled it out into puris like this. Now once these puris are fried, when they cool down, we'll dip them in this milk which will be reduced in consistency and also it will be sweetened along with some cardamom and saffron. So that is pal puri. So here I have some oil for frying the puris. Since we don't need the puris to be very hot, as we are going to dip them in the milk, we'll finish with the sweet dish first. So we'll first fry the puris. Now while the puris are frying side by side, I have kept here about 3 to 4 cups of milk you can take. Bring it to a boil and then allow it to reduce. Now depending on the number of persons for whom you are making the breakfast, you can adjust the puris and the milk required. If you take half a liter of milk, it will be sufficient for about 4 people. Our puris have been fried, milk is also boiling well and it is reducing in consistency. Now I'll add some sugar to it. I'm only going to add about 4 teaspoons of sugar because afterwards I'm going to add some condensed milk also to it. So then it should not become overly sweet. This will be fine. Just scrape the sides also. To this hot milk, we'll add a few strands of saffron. And a pinch of cardamom powder too. Our milk is now ready for the milk puri or pal puri. I'll remove this and keep it aside. Next we'll make the idlis. For idlis, I soaked 2 cups of idli rice and 1 cup of urandal for 3 hours. Then we ground them separately, mixed it together, added salt, allowed it to ferment overnight. Now this morning I am using this mini idli plate to make a mini idli and sambar. So just portion out small scoops of this idli batter onto this mold. If you don't have a mini idli plate, you can use your regular idli mold also. So keep water for boiling and when the water is boiling hot, keep your idli plate and steam it for 12 minutes. Now for the mini idli, we need sambar. First we'll make the masala for the sambar. Here I have taken 3 bedagi mirchis, or you can call them as Kashmiri mirchis. They give color but not very spicy. And these are the regular spicy red chilies.
two of them. Then I have taken 1 tablespoon of coriander seeds, 1 tablespoon of chana dal and 1/2 teaspoon of methi seeds. Methi is fenugreek. Now we will dry roast them and then blend them into a slightly coarse powder in a mixing jar. When all the spices are well roasted, remove it into your blender jar. Cool, we'll grind them into a powder. So we'll keep this masala aside. Meanwhile, while that is cooling, we can get ready with our sambar preparations. For the sambar, I have boiled 1/4 cup of pigeon pea lentils, that is tuvar dal, and 1/4 cup of split yellow moong dal together in the pressure cooker and kept it ready. Also, I have taken a lemon sized piece of tamarind and extracted the juice. We are going to use 1 onion, 2 tomatoes. I had a large size of radish, that is mooli. I have taken 1/2 of that and 1 capsicum. Now, some people, they don't eat onions and radish on Diwali day because it's an Amavasya also. So such persons can avoid these and proceed with the rest of the recipe. For all the recipes, if you are a person who does not eat onion, just omit the onion and proceed with the rest of the recipe. It will still taste good. Now heat some oil in a pan. Add the chopped onions and also the radish. You can add whatever vegetables you have at home. If you have drumstick, you can add. These are vegetables which will go good in a tiffin sambar. Lightly fry the onions and the radish till the onions change color a little bit. Also add in some curry leaves. And when the onions are half done, we can add this capsicum and chopped tomatoes also. Now stir everything well together till the tomatoes become very soft and mushy. We'll add some salt and also some haldi, that is turmeric powder. The tomatoes have softened. Now I'm adding this tamarind extract to it and allow it all to come to a boil till the raw smell of the tamarind goes away. Allow it to boil well. Meanwhile, I have switched off the idlis. They are done and ready. Just remove the idlis with a spoon like this. This plate has got 18 idlis. I have made 18 mini idlis like this. And then when the sambar is ready, just before serving, we will pour hot sambar over this. So this can also be kept aside. Here I have shown you only with 1 plate. I have a full stand with about 5 mini idli plates. So when you have for more people, you make the entire stand and make all the idlis. See, the sambar has been boiling well. Now I am going to add this ground sambar masala. Fresh sambar masala always tastes very good for a tiffin sambar. Next, we'll add in this cooked dal. I have not used all of the dal. I have kept some remaining because I don't want the sambar to become too thick. This dal we can use later on for making any rasam or dal or anything also. Now I am going to add more water to this. See, tiffin sambar is generally more dilute than the regular sambar which we make for rice. This is because when we dunk the idlis in this sambar, it absorbs the sambar. So if you have a little more dilute sambar, it is very good. Now allow this again to come to a boil. See, the sambar is boiling well. It has reached the right consistency. Just top it with some freshly chopped coriander leaves. This is perfect for tiffin sambar. We can switch it off. Finally, we'll do the tempering for the sambar. Heat some oil. For a still more better flavor, you can use some ghee for tempering. That will also taste good. And when it is hot, we'll add some mustard seeds to it, some hing, and pour it on top of the sambar. Ideally, the tiffin sambar, the traditional one, should have those small onions, baby onions or shallots. In today's times, I couldn't get that, so I have used the big onions. But if you have the small sambar onions, it will taste still better. This also tastes very good, of course. But to get the authentic taste, if you have the small onions, that is something a class apart. Okay, so now our idlis and sambar are both ready. Next we'll make a coconut chutney also. So this is some fresh grated coconut. I will take about 5 to 6 tablespoons of fresh grated coconut. I am adding 1 green chilli, small piece of ginger, and about 1 tablespoon of this roasted gram or bhuna chana. Add salt and grind everything together to a fine paste. Our chutney is perfectly ground and ready. It is a typical Getty chutney. And here I have some oil. We'll do the tempering with some mustard seeds and a little bit of urad dal. When the dals are well browned, remove it and pour it on the chutney. Next item on the menu is keerai vadai. Keerai refers to any greens. You can use whichever green leafy vegetable you get. Today I have got palak, so I have chopped palak and kept. Here I have soaked 1 cup of urad dal and 1/4 cup of chana dal. I soaked it for 2 hours, then drained the water, kept it out for draining totally. This is 1 tablespoon of moong dal also, which I had soaked. I have drained and kept it aside. Now we are going to grind this drained urad dal and chana dal to a coarse paste. Don't add water while grinding, just grind it to a coarse paste. See, I have ground it into a thick paste. So even if you need to add water, just sprinkle a few drops of water. Don't add much water. Now here I have some palak leaves, which I have washed and chopped finely. We'll add it to this. About 2 handfuls of palak you can take. Next, I have a small piece of ginger and 2 green chilies chopped. I'll just crush it and add it to that. This the crushed ginger and green chilies. Required quantity of salt. I've added a little bit of hing, about 1/4 teaspoon of hing, and we'll mix all these together very well. See, addition of these leaves and salt, everything will again make the batter a little bit more loose, because it will give out water. That's why we don't add lot of water in the beginning. This is the moong dal which we had soaked and strained. Finally, we'll add that also. I have not ground it because it gives a lovely appearance to the vadai and a nice crunchy bite also. Now mix it well. Keep some oil for deep frying the vadais. Now take a ball of this batter, place it on the leaf like this. If you don't have a banana leaf, you can use a steel plate or a plastic sheet, whatever you have. Just press it down like this and make a small hole in the center. Now when the oil is hot, gently slide this butter into the oil. The size you can make them big or small as per your choice. After some time, just flip them over like this. And once you add the vadas, cook them over a medium flame. Don't keep the flame too high because you want it to have a nice crunchy effect and at the same time be well cooked. When it gets a lovely golden color and the bubbling also reduces, we can drain it out from the oil. Likewise, make with the remaining vada batter also. See, our heera vadas are fried and ready. Now we have only one more item to make, that is the rava khichdi. For the rava khichdi, I have taken 1 cup of rava, that is semolina or suji, the regular one which we use for upma. Apart from that, I have chopped 2 onions, and here I have some frozen green peas, some beans, carrot and tomatoes also chopped, 2 green chilies chopped and some curry leaves also. Now heat about 3 tablespoons of oil. For 1 cup of rava, I have taken about 3 cups of water and kept it for boiling. So when the oil is hot, we'll add some mustard seeds, add some urad dal, chana dal. Allow these dals to fry well in the oil. Some of you tell me that the chana dal is hard to bite. If it gets fried in the oil, it will not be hard to bite. If you still have that problem, then soak the chana dal for about 10 minutes in water and then add. But generally we add like this, there is no problem at all. Next, add some onions and green chilies and lightly fry them. Add a few fresh curry leaves also, and these are some frozen peas, about a tablespoon, 3 or 4 French beans I have chopped, carrots, out of these whatever you have you can add, and tomatoes. Add a pinch of turmeric powder to this and also some salt. Fry everything well together till the vegetables are nearly cooked. Next, I am adding this rava to it, that is the semolina. See, whenever I buy semolina, I immediately dry roast it and keep it. One is, it prevents the insects from coming. Secondly, when we have to make any upma or khichdi, it becomes faster. You don't have to again roast the rava. Just a slight roasting now along with the vegetables is fine. If you have not roasted the rava earlier, then first dry roast the rava for a couple of minutes till it slightly changes color, and then you can start with this process. Now this water is also boiling and hot, so we pour this water into this khichdi. those of you who have visited Saravana Bhavan Hotel, in whichever part of the world, they have branches in so many cities all over the world, would have tasted this khichdi. It's quite popular over there. Reduce the flame, cover it and just cook it for 2 or 3 minutes till done. See, now our khichdi is done and ready. We can remove this. We have prepared all the items. We are ready to serve. See, we have taken the mini idlis in this. So, we will just pour some hot sambar onto this. Top it up with a drop of ghee. Next, for this pal poli, we have taken the puris, just fold it like this, and this is a lavang or clove. We can just press it into it like this so that it doesn't open out. And then now here I told you we are going to add some condensed milk also to this. Just add about 1 or 2 spoons of condensed milk to this and mix it well. Now pour this on top of these puris. Top it up with whatever dry fruits you have, pista or melon seeds or badam slivers, and it is ready. Next, we have our keera vadai, that is the palak vadai, and the upma, sorry, the khichdi. I have taken it out in a bowl like this and I have greased the bowl so that we get the shape as it is. Top it up with a piece of fried kaju, and of course not to forget the lovely thick chutney, coconut chutney, you can add over here. Lovely tasty Deepavali brunch is ready. We have mini idli and sambar, rava khichdi, keera vade, coconut chutney and pal poli. So I am sure you can all enjoy this. I am giving it to you a day ahead of time. Just a quick recap, the things you have to do on the previous day: soak the rice and dal for idli, make the batter, keep it overnight for fermenting. Next morning you can make the idli. Morning, as soon as you get up, soak the dal for the vada. After 2 hours, grind it and you can make the vada. Then all you have to do is just boil the dal and everything else you just go step by step as I have shown in the video. Wishing you all a very happy Deepavali from all of us.
Diwali! Happy Diwali!
Happy Diwali!
Okay.
Happy Diwali!
Happy birthday!
Okay.
Yeah.
Thank you for watching the video. Please subscribe to Geeta's Kitchen. We'll meet again with another interesting video from Geeta's Kitchen. Thank you.